And you have to look at it, although they look at the universe in different ways, they share an interest in evidence. So, for instance, I was drawn to the Christian faith at the age of 17, as it happens, because of its emphasis upon evidence, religious experience in lots of different people, the fact that the universe itself poses questions which science itself can't answer, such as where do the beauty and intelligibility of the physical laws come from, and most importantly for me, the evidence of the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus of Nazareth.
There's no evidence for that.
Professor Wilkinson, I want Andrew to come in. Go on, what did you just say? There's no evidence for that.
I mean, Francesca will know more about this than I do as a scholar of the Bible, but of course there's substantial evidence that most of the Bible, well, there's a lack of evidence that most of the Bible is true. Mm. I think this is actually just the sort of self-deception that is a worry when science and religion do commingle, is that, I mean, I can't see, for example, why historical claims about things that happen in the Bible, for example, shouldn't be subject to exactly the same tests of evidence as anything else. That's the scientific method at work in every area of our life.
Yes.
And I feel that some...
Just let him finish, Professor Wilkinson, I'll bring
him
back in.
Sometimes people who say things like that are the victims of self-deception. I mean, as I say, Francesca is the biblical scholar, so she'll have more to say about
it. But you think Professor Wilkinson's a victim of self-deception?
It sounded like that from what he was saying then. I think so, and Francesca's nodding, which means gives me support.
Scientific backing. Professor Wilkinson,
and what's the evidence
your
for
response?
Yeah, I think the historical evidence does need to be sifted. I'm not arguing against that, and I really take exception to being called self-deceived on this. I teach theology. I'm part of a university at Durham which takes theology and historical evidence within the Bible extremely seriously and takes the academic component of that extremely seriously.
But you do
seriously.
Teach theology, which is about religious belief, whereas I teach biblical studies, which is about the examination of ancient literature. So I do think we're approaching the evidence, as it were, from quite different perspectives. There's no evidence for a resurrection.